Today we'll explore the to-sum LeetCode problem. It's an easy problem and we are given an array of nums and an integer target. And we need to find two elements in that array so that when we add them, we get target. In the response, we must return an array with an indexes of those two elements in nums. And there are two extra rules. We can't use the same element twice, and there is exactly one solution. In this example, the target is 9, so the two elements we are looking for are 2 and 7, with indices 0 and 1 respectively, which should be returned in the result. So we go over the array, and for each element we calculate its sum with every other element in the array and compare it with the target. The space complexity is O of 1. Because we don't use any extra space. Let's try to find a better solution. Take any element in the array. Instead of adding it to every other element, notice that the complement we need is target minus element. If we can find the complement in the array, we have solved the problem. However, looking for the complement in the array still takes O of n times per element. Is there a data structure that checks membership faster than O of n? Yes, and this is a hash map. We can go over the array once and insert all its elements in the hash map, using the element values as keys and their indexes as values. We need O of n operations to build the map, and another O of n to iterate through the array, compute each complement and look it up in the map. Therefore, the overall complexity is O of n plus O of n, which gives us O of n in terms of complexity because we can just throw away any constants. And the space complexity is O of n. Instead of loading the entire array into the map first, we can build that map lazily, iterating through the array only once. The time complexity is still O of n, but the constant factor is lower. Let's call this specific solution in LeetCode. So first we will define the map. This map will store our elements and their indices. Next we need to iterate through the array once. We define complement as target minus current element in nums array. Then we will define complement index, which we will determine based on our hash map. Notice that initially our map is empty, so complement index will be null. So let's do the check. Basically what we wrote, we checked that complement index is not null. And in case it is not null, it means that we have found our element. So we need just to return int array of, and we should provide two elements. First is index of current element, which is I, and second is just this complement index, which is an it variable inside of the let block. In case we have not found the element in our map, we just place it in our elements map. We store the current element as key of the map and its current position as its index. And in case we have finished our cycle but we haven't found anything, we need to throw some exception. We do it just for the sake of the compiler because it expects int array, and we have to either return something here or to throw an exception. But it will be never thrown here because by the definition of the task, there is always exactly one solution. So let's try to run the code. We see that all three cases passed, and let's submit the solution. So, as you can see, it's passed, the runtime is 2 milliseconds, and the complexity is linear, just as expected. So we have solved this problem. This is an easy problem, but it shows an important concept. We can solve a problem much more efficiently simply by choosing the right data structure. Thanks for watching. See you soon.